Welcome to this session. So today I'm going to take the session on that is business law. So under the business law, I'm taking about the offer. So under the offer, we have dealt with the legal rules as to offer. So today is the ninth point, that is about the specific. An offer may be specific or general. So specific offer is the offer which is made to a specific person. Here only that specific person, particular person, can answer that offer, that is give his acceptance towards that offer. But the general offer is, that is public at large. So public at large means, for example, the advertisement which is given in the newspaper, it can be taken by any of the person. So here the person, one who reads that newspaper, he can give his assent or the acceptance. Okay, so that is giving advertisement, that is in the newspaper, so anybody can give the acceptance. So here one of the famous cases about Carlyle versus Carbolic Smoke Ball Company. Carlyle versus Carbolic Smoke Ball Company. Here it says that Carbolic smoke ball company, they give an advertisement, that is in the newspaper, that is about if any person who contacts influenza by having the smoke ball which is given, that is under the advertisement. Okay, so in that case, if anyone contacts influenza after having that smoke ball, in that case the person, one who contacts influenza, he will get the reward of, that is 100. Here it is not the reward, compensation, okay, which is given by the smoke ball company only when the person contacts influenza after having that smoke ball. Okay, so here the fellow, that is the Carlyle, she took that smoke ball. So after taking that smoke ball, she contacts influenza. So as per the advertisement which is given in the newspaper by the Carbolic smoke ball company, that if anyone contacts influenza, then they will give the compensation of rupees 100, right? That is the 100 pounds. So here what happens is, after contacting influenza, that is by the Mrs. Carlyle, so she goes to the company and she asks for the compensation of 100 pounds. Now, Carbolic Smoke Ball Company, they refuse to give that 100 pounds, that is to Miss Carlyle. So Carlyle, so she sued court. So after filing the case against that Carbolic Smoke Ball Company, so court sees that, then court gives a judgment, that is in favor of Carlyle. Why? Because the advertisement was given in the newspaper and the offer is made by the Carbolic Smoke Ball Company, that is under the newspaper, which is in the newspaper. So by giving the advertisement, so it is called as what? That is a general offer. So here general offer is an offer which is public at large. Any person can give the acceptance. So here Mrs. Carlyle has given the acceptance by taking that smoke ball. So it is in favor of Mrs. Carlyle. So Carbolic Smoke Ball Company had to give the compensation of 100 pounds, that is to Mrs. Carlyle. So this is about the general offer. So this was the ninth legal rules as to valid offer. And the next is about an offer may be positive or negative. So it is one of the type of offer. So positive offer or the negative offer. So positive offer is nothing but to do something, but negative offer is not to do something. So positive offer, it can be, if I say, for example, I will sell my scooter, that is for rupees 8000, then it is called as positive. Okay, negative offer is if I say, you don't sue on me, I will give you rupees 100, then it is called as a negative, that is to not to do something. If any person wants to give a case that is against you, in that case, if you give some extra money, okay, in that case, it is called as a negative offer. So it is offer, but it is a negative offer. Okay, so that is about the positive offer or the negative offer. The next point is, an offer becomes effective only when it is communicated to the other party, that is to the offeree. So there are two parties, offerer and the offeree. One who offers, he is called as the offerer. One who accepts that offer, then he is called as the offeree. Okay, so yeah, it becomes effective only when it is communicated to the other party. So offer should be, if I want to offer to some other person, then I have to communicate. It may be by express or it may be by implied. So anything, you have to communicate. Here one of the case law is that Lalman versus Gauri Dutt. Lalman versus Gauri Dutt. Here the Gauri Dutt is a person, one who sends his servant, that is Lalman, to trace his missing nephew. So Lalman is a servant. So here Gauri Dutt, he sends the servant to trace his missing nephew. Okay, after his departure, he announces that is Gauri Dutt announces that is at public. So one who trace his missing nephew, then he will be giving, that is reward of ₹501. Now Lalman is unaware of this fact. Okay, so unaware of this fact, so he brings, he traces his that is Gauri Dutt's missing nephew, and he takes back that missing nephew. After that, he comes to know that the Gauri Dutt had told something, that is he will be giving ₹501 as a reward, one who brings his missing nephew, one who traces his missing nephew. So Lalman, what he does now, he go to the Gauri Dutt and he asks for the reward of ₹501. Why? Because he had traced his missing nephew. So Gauri Dutt, what he does now, he refused to give that ₹501. So Lalman, he filed a suit, that is in the court. So for today, we'll end up this. So thank you.